Brighton and Hove Albion, a club that's all too familiar with the highs and lows of football. Located on England's south coast, they've competed in all of the country's top four divisions since their founding in 1901. But it was in 2017 that their 34-year wait for top-flight football ended under the coaching of Chris Hughton. Now in their seventh season in the Premier League, the Seagulls are flying high domestically and are among the European elite in the Europa League. But this dizzying success is in stark contrast to the issues of the 1990s, when two relegations and financial turmoil saw the club lose their stadium at Goldstone Lane and almost their existence. A ground share in Gillingham, Kent, a different county, followed. Thankfully, in 1997, Brighton had a saviour in the form of local businessman and lifelong fan, Dick Knight, who brought the club back to Brighton, to the Whitdean Stadium, and changed the club's trajectory forever.
I first saw Brighton in 1946. I had supported the club since I was a little boy. I was determined to do everything that was necessary to save the club. We turned it into a fortress. We were back in Brighton, that was the key thing. And every game was full. It required money, but it also needed the determination and a desire to actually save the club. The players loved playing here because it was so unique. It was the most successful period in the club's history. We had four promotions in 12 years from here. You know, so it was incredible. Whitdean has its own part to play in the history of this football club. And I'm so glad that we came here, we fought against every obstacle that we had on the pitch and off the pitch. And that was our main noise centre in the game, full of Brighton fans, everyone singing Sussex by the Sea. Great atmosphere. We created an atmosphere here. I'm looking forward to continuing my love affair with the Albion, because for me, my devotion to the club is approaching its 10th decade. It's incredible to go from watching a team bottom of the lowest level of English football, which we were when I took over, to now watching one of the best club teams in the world. From signing players on a shoestring to breaking the British transfer record, it's a measure of progress we've made. For me and every Brighton fan, this is pure fantasy now. Last Thursday night, the result was almost irrelevant. It was the experience of actually being there. It was a very proud day for me to actually be there and see the team play in Europe for the first time ever. I'm very proud.
Having led from the boardroom for 12 years, Dick Knight relinquished his role in 2009. One of the people best positioned to appreciate his efforts is a fan and now club captain, Lewis Dunk, who joined Brighton's academy during Knight's tenure.
Everyone's grateful for what he's done for the club, and this football club wouldn't be in Europe now if it weren't for him. So everyone in the city and every Brighton fan would say the same as me. It's massive. It's everything. It's all I've known. I've been here since a little kid, and now I'm an adult and still playing it. Thankfully, it's an amazing club to come to every day with amazing people in it, and I've been lucky that I've been able to do it at my hometown club and stay here for so long and still be improving and improving as a club.
Since Tony Bloom's takeover from Knight in 2009, the club has gone from strength to strength. A move to the Brighton and Hove Community Stadium in 2011 was the foundations of the club's development. But the appointment of current manager Roberto De Zerbi was the catalyst for their first bow in Europe. And they won't be disheartened by their matchday one loss to AEK Athens.
Playing football in Europe is way past than I thought this football club would go, but yeah, if you ask the chairman here, he'll go against me and say the other way, where he always saw it going in this direction. An incredible journey, and I'm been lucky enough to be a part of the whole way through. It's been a slow rise, and a rise in the right way, because the club's running the right way. It took a lot of hard work to get to this moment, and I think I'm proud of the way it's gone. It's been incredible.
Coming up, exclusive access to Danish side FC Nordsjælland.